tournament, as these two teams have a great complement of both, but only one can go into the semi-final.
Yeah, and it's difficult to split them actually, and see what they've shown so far. Plenty of plus points from them. Each staff is in this case that can score goals. Let's hope we have a few.
I think the women's game now running in tandem with the men's game, with all the different competitions, European Championships, World Cups. It's a very exciting development, and there's no doubt that the standards are going up with the intensity of the competition.
I think the players involved, what they would be encouraged by is the fact that the crowds seem to be getting bigger, and the profile on television and the media has increased over the years.
There's no doubt, as broadcasters, we get invited to cover women's tournaments as much as men's tournaments now, which would never have happened 20, 25 years ago.
Yeah, I mean, I think the level of competition in these tournaments now makes it more appealing to a worldwide audience, you might say.
Here's Dahlqvist. Well, they're in a good position here. From the goal, and went for it. That's it now. That's a great start. They've got the range straight away. Great goal coming from their first shot of the game.
What a goal. The crowd are on the feet. First time finish. It was a thrilling sight.
So the first goal is 1-0. Jennifer Marisan. Some potential in this move. This is an exercise in patience as they try to get an opening. Strong tackle to break up the play. Nicely played through ball. Marisan! Terrific stop! Corner. Great defending there, stopping that attack. Real high quality in the women's game in Germany. Jennifer Marisan, who will certainly catch her eyes today, Alan.
Yeah, I mean, she's not old now by any means. She's only 23, but youngest ever player to play in the German Bundesliga at just 14 years and 7 months.
That's Mani! That's a very worthy effort. She outside the post. Jennifer Kramer. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. To get the equaliser. And the equaliser here. Made it look very easy. I mean, it isn't always as easy as this. You say two should always score against the one goalkeeper, but nobody panicked.
No, nobody did. I think they realised they had time. They realised they'd broken through, and it was 2-1, and they made it count.
So away we go at 1-1. Now Berglund. Now Aslani. Now Rubensson, good forward play from them. Eye-catching football, really. It just got to a stage where they actually took the eye off the ball, literally, and they've lost the ball. Leonard Peterman comes in with a tackle. Here's Applequist. Really on top of their game now. Wonderful understanding. And that is one pass too many, and at the end they've given the ball away. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here. Leonard Peterman. Good strong tackle. Sege. Applequist. his club. That's going to run on through to the goalkeeper. That's in the remit now of the referee. Players not encouraged to put the ball out. It's stopped because the referee says this player needs some treatment. And the substitution is going to happen now for the injured player.
And it looks as if it's like for like. Shouldn't change the system too much.
Well, the injured player has gone off. We're going to get the game restarted with a drop ball. In the quarter-final, no real pointers so far, Alan, they're still level.
Yeah, they've just been feeling each other out. It's been...
And this is the start of the second half. Working hard just to see... Maybe a sight of goal. Good tackle. Will be a corner though.
And heads it towards goal.
That's not a good corner at all.
Well, it's a chance, isn't it, to put the team under pressure, but they've just wasted that chance completely.
Good challenge. Here's a chance to attack. Promising build-up until that challenge. Rubensson. Well, good through ball. Here's an opportunity. It's a shot now. Nielsen. Really the way to get the ball out of the danger zone. Well, there's going to be a substitution now. Running steadily here, keeping possession. We've had an hour gone here, and still 30 minutes left. Trying to thread it through here. Nothing wrong with that tackle. In fact, it was a terrific effort. Strong, fair challenge, pulls out for a throw though. There's some potential in this move. Now Aslani. Now Tetema. Here comes substitution now. Able to make a good interception. The pass not completed, really. Got to be. With the charge well taken. And they now lead the game. She's shown a great touch in front of goal to grab both of them, really. Well, there's a goal worth replaying over and over again, isn't it? Off we go again, 2-1. See so often the impact of substitutes. We're going to see a substitution here. I think we've got the possession stats so far for you coming up on the screen.
Nothing to split the two sides. So when you're looking for somebody to pick out the hole, throughout the pass, throughout the goal.
Good through pass. For sure, is it? cut it out. Tackle here. Looking good, this move.
Shots on here.
Well, a corner to come because of that deflection. Back corner. It's been a real disappointment. He's gone out for a throw on the other side of the field. 7 more minutes to go. Now they're looking to get forward from this position. On to the attack now. They've got it away from the danger. That's going to be a free kick late in the game now. Could be dangerous. And the time to be added on here is a minimum of 3 minutes. Well, this is how this team... Free kick given. Rash, Alan, reckless?
Yeah, I think so. It was a poor tackle. It was badly timed.
One more opportunity. Final whistle goes. The game is over. And the final score, 2-1. This great cup run is going on. They've got the right results here in the quarterfinal. They're into the last four.
They've totally deserved as well.